Oh. Oh. That's not
Basically, we build a shoebox-sized car that competes in April against other chemical engineering departments. And what this car does is it bears a certain weight load and has to go a certain distance. We have a power source team, a stopping mechanism team, a chassis team, an electronics team.
Yeah, so we're the power generation team. Basically, what we're responsible for is making the power that actually runs the car's motors.
So our cold side of the thermoelectric generator is just going to be ice water, but our hot side is an exothermic dissociation of sulfuric acid, and it releases a lot of heat.
So this is a Peltier cell, a thermoelectric generator. One side goes up against a hot source or a heat sink, and one goes up against a cold source or a cold sink. And the temperature differential between them produces a voltage, which then serves as our power source. So we ended up getting Christmas tins because it was right in the beginning of December, and we ended up at Joann Fabrics at like 8:30 p.m. And it adds a nice aesthetic look to the car.
So we're hosting the AIChE conference this year, the Northeast Regional AIChE conference, and University of Rochester and RIT are hosting that jointly.
So Allison really likes koalas, so we decided to be the Koala-ty engineers, and we built the koala mobile.
So basically what we do for our stopping mechanism is we have a photometer and there's an HCl sodium thiosulfate reaction going on, and it turns opaque after a certain amount of time. Once that turns opaque, it turns off the photometer and it sends a signal to the solid state relay to stop giving power to the car.
Oh. We announce the target distance and the weight of water they have to carry 1 hour before the competition, so the teams all have 1 hour to prep their experiments. So it's a great opportunity for the students to, you know, work on their problem-solving skills. You know, every team gets two chances to complete the run, so the first time is usually, you know, kind of their baseline, and then they go make further adjustments, and then they improve on the second run. We set them up at the start line. They're all going to try to get as close as they can to the target distance. We have to be very precise with the measurements because sometimes these competitions, the cars will be within millimeters of each other.
You got 2 minutes on the clock for your car.
Definitely put a lot of work into the car, and it's great to see it like actually work out in competition.
Our first round today, it didn't stop, but we got it to start and got it to stop amidst like 2-3 years of effort, and four of us are graduating, so it's exciting.
It's been a really rewarding experience. I've met some really great people, and it's been a really fun experience to just like see this process from beginning to end.